Everyone, runner.
Morning.
You're not everyone. We're on our way back to the doctor's. Val has an appointment with her urologist. Is that who it is?
Yeah.
So we have some questions to ask. We got some. She's having some issues. So after that, we're going to do what?
Go home and go back to bed.
Well, maybe you'll go home and go back to bed.
We have to stop and get crickets for all the critters upstairs today. And guess what happens to be in the same parking lot?
Are you talking about soup?
Nope.
What?
Jack in the Box, and that hamburger was yummy, yummy, yummy. Maybe we could get some kind of burger before we get the crickets?
Before the crickets? Yeah, I guess. Do you want to sit down?
Yes, we gotta sit down.
Alright. We don't have to. We can take it home. But we can do that.
I'm gonna have some kind of burger again today. Yay! So guys, as Kevin said, we are heading back to my doctor's, my urologist appointment. It's just a follow-up from my surgery, but I am having some issues that we do need to discuss with him, and we'll see what happens.
So I think since you parked at Red Lobster, I think you need to take me to Red Lobster for lunch.
Why is that? Why do you think that?
Because this way it's less wear and tear on the truck.
What happened to some kind of burger?
Lobster truck top some kind of burger any day.
Okay.
So, since Kevin parked in Red Lobster, which is across the street from the hospital, I'm using this time as counting my sports tracker.
Hello.
And doing my walking.
Yeah, so you're getting your walking in anyway.
Well, I don't think it'll be a quarter of a mile, okay. But it'll be something.
Well, we got some running around to do still. Nice out here.
It's hot. I'm sweating.
Nice and warm.
This walk made it too hot for me. Stop. 0.40 miles. What is that?
0.40 miles?
Yeah.
That's over a quarter of a mile.
What is a quarter of a mile?
0.25.
Look at how close we are to Red Lobster. Look at how close we are to Red Lobster.
We're getting farther and farther away.
Buckhead.
Now, isn't this better than Red Lobster?
I haven't eaten it yet, but I wonder if you can get some dip for my french fries.
Probably could. And I've got greasy tacos. It is Tuesday, you know. So it's Greasy Taco Tuesday.
Same burger as the other night. Still very good.
Greasy tacos. Yum.
Can you open these for me?
Yes, dear.
Kevin found his new bedspread.
Hope that got.
Okay. It's 81 degrees.
Feels good.
It's too hot. We are going home. We are closing up the house,
no.
And we are putting the air conditioning
I
on.
I don't think so.
Yes.
It's not.
It's 81 degrees.
It feels good.
It's hot.
It's not hot. How long have you lived in California? It gets to 115 in the summer.
I know, and that's why I don't go out of the house.
I'd like to move to the desert. That'd be nice. It's good for your skin.
You go move to the desert, I'll move to the mountains, and you come up and visit me.
So Valtra doesn't trust me, so she's gonna feed them.
This is how you bread chicken.
So we're feeding them live bugs as opposed to dead stuff. Come on, you know what's coming.
There's one.
There they go. Whoa.
There goes Frick and Frack.
And it's on. Boom.
Okay, so now we're going to feed Puff Daddy and Rufio.
These guys are mad because
everybody else got fed first.
Yeah. Nom. Nom. You've got to swallow the whole thing. Thank you very much.
You're getting your water filthy. You know that.
Fed the animals and now we're finally sitting down. So I thought I'd update everybody on the doctors. I'm still running a slight fever. The surgery for my bladder, that's what this appointment was for, just to follow up. Everything seemed fine from that. They are going to do a full CAT scan of my entire stomach. Is that
your abdomen.
My entire abdomen.
Down to your pelvis because you're having pains.
Yeah.
Which is really good. I'm happy they're doing that.
Even though I have had a complete hysterectomy back in the late 90s, he still wants me to go to a gynecologist. He's saying the pains that I'm having is more along that type of an area. I could have scar tissue, and that could be what's causing a lot of my lower right abdominal pain. Mm-hmm. I'm doing okay now, other than being tired and run down. Still got to follow up on my shoulder and on my elbow. But we're going to watch some ghost stuff and do some computer work.
But there's some Star Trek on TV.
And we are getting our shirts set up because since I've mentioned shirts or since we've opened our shirts for Christmas that Brett got us, everybody has been talking about wanting shirts. So we are moving ahead with that. So catch y'all a little later.
Star Trek!
Catch y'all a little later!
Do I look all right?
Yes, dear.
I have to reprogram you. Your monotone, your yesters are getting kind of monotone there.
Yes, dear.
It's time for Neighborhood Community Credit Roll!
Why you look angry?
Oh.
There's no reason to be angry at them.
Okay.
Tell them you're sorry.
I've got my eye on you.
I think you got both of your eyes on them.
Oh, okay. Well, go ahead.
Well, you got to start, because this one's for you. Nah.
Jamie V, welcome to the neighborhood. And yes, this is my big steppin' hat from Aaron Goodwin, Ghost Adventures. Saturday. It'll be on Saturday, and they're investigating the Bellwitch Cave.
That's going to be an exciting one. I like that one. Well, I like that story. So. Okay. Kate 2's weight loss. Welcome to the neighborhood. And I hope her and I are going to, like, mindfully walk together and help each other. Yeah,
because,
you know, like, she's going to be telling me in my mind, keep walking, keep walking.
Oh, okay.
And I'm going to be telling her, keep walking, keep walking. And we're going to walk together.
All
right. So, right, Kate? Katie 2.
two
S's. Just say yes, dear.
Just do what he does. Say yes, dear. He's walking with me.
Drizeta Molina.
Drizeta Molina. Welcome to the neighborhood. And shout out to you. Cummins. Is that supposed to be an S in there?
Yeah, I think so. Cummins Power.
Cummins Power 01. Welcome to the neighborhood. Update on Taylor Berry's family. Remember her family got in an accident. Her stepdad's name is Ryan. Found that much out. Her mother, Stacy, and her sister, Madison. They were all still, they had to stay in the hospital. Ryan ended up with stitches and bruised up, bumped and bruised. Mom Stacy ended up with a broken wrist, bumped and bruised. Her sister Madison got the brunt of the accident. She was impaled with glass that went all the way through her shoulder. And she had to get stitches in her back by her ribs. And they will all be home on Wednesday, which is tomorrow. So thank you everyone for keeping them in your thoughts and prayers. And please continue to do so for their quick recovery. And Caitlin McDowell, welcome to the neighborhood. And another prayer, guys. Her 80-year-old grandma had a stroke a few days before Christmas. And they just found out today that she has cancer. And it's coming up on the 2-year anniversary from when her grandfather died. So Caitlin is very, very upset. She's very sad, and it's a tough time. If you guys can all send Caitlin and her family lots of love and support, she could really use it at this time. So Caitlin, we do love you, and we do have you in our thoughts and prayers as well. Mom's Vlog 80, go subscribe to their channel. Fantastic family. Melody, the mother, and the one son, Elijah, are leaving to go to Stanford for a week. And Ronnie and Caden, the father and their other son, are going to be staying home. Elijah, at age 3, was diagnosed with neuroblastoma stage 4 cancer. So they're going to Stanford for a week. And they may be staying at the Ronald McDonald House there. And if they do, they're going to give us a tour. And he starts his scans this week for his cancer. She is going to link the Facebook fan page. I'm also going to link the Facebook fan page down there. She is doing a Couch to 5K walk to raise money for other families with children that have cancer and in need of financial assistance. So please, everybody, go check out her channel, give her a big thumbs up, and subscribe and follow along. She's a fantastic, the whole family is fantastic, and she's got a fantastic voice. She sings, she's a beautiful singer. So that's all I have as far as shout outs go. Okay, it's time for Neighborhood Community Credit Roll. Oh, and we did add some new people to the credit rolls. So I don't know if anybody bye. I didn't do my other part.
Do you think that?
He's waiting. You are all part of our neighborhood community, each and every one of you. We would not be here if it weren't for all of you. We do thank you very much. We love you all. We love you all. Thumbs up, and we will see you.